It is possible to make people contented with their servitude. I think this can be done. I think it has been done in the past, but I think it could be done even more effectively now, because you can provide them with bread and circuses, and you can provide them with endless amounts of distractions and propaganda.
We portray ourselves, and so we are accepted.
I am encouraged this morning with news coming out of the EU that we, knock wood, so far seem to be escaping the blacklist or the grey list or any other kind of list, but as known as a well-regulated and corporate jurisdiction.
The persons running the unsaid Earth Summit are actually setting a net to place the power over the Earth and its peoples into their hands. Whose hands? The same World Order families that planned World War I and World War II, that tricked the Third World countries to borrow funds and rack up enormous debts. The same World Order that stole much of the money borrowed by Africans and other nations and hid it in Geneva banks. At the Fourth World Congress meeting in 1987, some other bad remarks about common people were made. I'm going to play them for you now. For instance, here is David Lang, a Montreal international investment banker, decreeing that these environment and economic activities of the world order not be shared with the public. He calls us cannon fodder. Listen to this.
I suggest, therefore, that this be sold not through a democratic process. That would take too long and devour far too much of the funds to educate the cannon fodder, unfortunately, which populates the earth. We have to take almost an elitist program that we can see beyond our swollen bellies and look to the future in time frames and in results to educate the cannon fodder, unfortunately, which populates.